Of course, the invasion wasn't just by air. Thousands of cars rolling in from as early as 1 o'clock in the morning. And despite fears of long delays, it was a smooth ride.
Behind every steering wheel, there was a story.
See, how long have you been out?
3 months.
Where's home?
Redcliffe.
Guess where we are? Yeah. Guess where we are? We're in Queensland.
Breathe in that Queensland air, mate. How does it feel?
Beautiful. It's good.
Sunshine State bound, many served the final moments of their months-long lockout in the dead of night and in a traffic queue. Permits, PCR tests and proof of vaccination. The fear was the rush to cross the border would just extend the agony.
Nearly there. Nearly there.
Queensland's biggest police operation since the 2018 Commonwealth Games. And so far, so good.
We have not had long delays. On the N1 currently, it is up to 20 minutes. In other areas, just up to 10 minutes.
There's nobody. We got up at 4 o'clock this morning to come through, and there's nobody. It's fantastic.
At Gundawindi, it was a clear run over the crossing before floodwaters got in the way. Another delay, but they took it in their stride.
If it ends up happening, we can't get through, we'll stay at the Guns Inn for a couple of nights.
The reunions were not limited to the airport. At Coolangatta, there were hugs on the footpath for Anna and Mark following a mercy dash there.
You were looking after a sick relative?
My mother.
Yeah, and that was 3 months ago?
Yes.
How is it to be home?
Fantastic.
Back in the queue, people relished what was ahead of them.
Good to be able to drive over the border and see Mum and Dad for Christmas. That's the main thing.
No more FaceTiming for these new grandparents.
It's going to be interesting to see our grandson, who's going to see us in live, you know.
Nathan Irvine's cafe sits right on the border, cashing in as the cars rolled in.
So we've gone through all those headaches and hopefully we've come out the other side now and we're open. Everyone get to Queensland. Beautiful.
And as the welcome home party begins, the Premier was reluctant to spoil the fun. But there are no guarantees.
Premier, is this the end of lockdowns for Queensland?
I hope so.
Damien Ryan, Nine News.
The border war with Queensland might be over, but there are still a few hoops to jump through if you're travelling north. Mark Burrows explains.
Restrictions still hang over the border. Anyone over 16 who wishes to enter must be fully vaccinated, but kids under 16 don't have to be. You'll need a negative PCR test within 72 hours before entering the state. And you'll need a follow-up test on day 5 of your stay or as close to it. Those are free at any state clinic and your text message results will suffice. The final step is the entry pass available from the Queensland Government website. It takes less than 5 minutes to complete. You'll need to bring that either on paper or your phone, along with your ID, your vax certificate and test results. Once you've arrived, you're subject to Queensland's close contact rules. At the moment, that's 14 days isolation, but from January the 1st, that's down to 7. So, a few steps, but it'll be worth it to reunite with family, go on holiday, or to hear those words again. Welcome to Queensland.
Now to news on the WA border, which will remain closed until February. Tracy Vo joins us from Perth. Tracy, after months of waiting, Premier Mark McGowan has finally announced a date.
Georgie, that date is February 5, more than 7 weeks to go until WA reconnects with the rest of the nation. It's been 616 days since those tough border controls were put in place by the WA government. But from February 5, travellers can fly freely between the states and internationally. But there are some requirements. International travellers will need to produce a negative test within 72 hours of departure and 48 hours of arriving here in WA. Those fully vaccinated won't be required to quarantine. Domestically, all those travellers will need to be fully vaccinated. Anyone who's staying here for 6 days or more, they will also need to produce some negative results similar to those international travellers. But just repeating, from February 5, WA will reconnect with the rest of the nation. But for those families looking to reunite, they're facing more of a weight of that moment. Georgie?
OK, Tracy, thank you.